So you put one chain on your hook, and let's get started with chain three. One, two, three. Now you go back to the first chain and you put your hook underneath two strands and make one double crochet. That means that you have two double crochets in a row right now, plus one additional double crochet. That makes three in a row. 3 plus 2 is 1. So, 3 chains plus 2 is 1. Sorry. Now, chain 1 and turn. If you'd rather make chain 3, it's up to you, but I prefer to make a chain 1 and start directly with a double crochet in the first stitch. That way, you don't get any gaps on the sides. 1 double crochet in the first. In the second, 1 double crochet. And in the third stitch, that's your chain three, so you need to search for the third chain from the bottom on. In that chain, the third chain, you make two double crochets in the same stitch underneath two loops. From now on, when you do it like I do with a chain one, you don't have a third chain to put your hook under, so that makes work a bit easier. Chain one and turn. In the first stitch, you make two double crochets. Is the first and the second. Now you double crochet throughout this row, one double crochet in each stitch. So that's the third double crochet, the fourth double crochet, and the last one is here in that chain one that I made to start the next row with. So in here you make your double crochet. Now you have in total 5 doubles in a row, 2 in the first and 3 in a row. Only on this side we will increase. This one will be straight, so one line straight up. Only at this side here. Now we have cut 5 double crochets. You will make chain 1, turn your work. In the first you make 1 double crochet because this is a straight line here, straight edge. In the second, third and fourth, you'll make one double crochet. That's number two, number three and number four. And in the last, that's the chain one that I made before, you make two doubles. Here it is, the chain one, which I made to turn my work. In that one, you'll make two double crochets. So this is number two. Chain one and turn. So now we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 doubles in a row. I already made my chain one. So in the first, again, two double crochets. That is number one and number two. Now in all the other stitches you make one double crochet. So this is number three in a row, number four, the fifth double crochet, number six, and in the last one that will be the turning chain that I make. Here it is. So I've got 7 double crochets in a row right now. Chain one and turn. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yes, 7 doubles. Now we start with the repeating pattern. We start only this row with 3 doubles in a row, and then with the pattern but further on we only have 4 doubles on each side. But you will see it later on. In the first stitch, 1 double crochet, and in the second and the third as well. Make sure that you go underneath 2 loops instead of 1. This is number 2 and number 3. Now chain 1, skip one stitch, and in the next two you make each one double crochet. So that's number one and number two, and in the last stitch two double crochets. There's number one and number two. Now I've got four doubles in this side. You will keep on crocheting with four doubles on the on this side here. Every time a group of four will come at it. So I will show you. Chain one and turn. In the first you make two double crochets. That's number one, because this is the diagonal edge. This is number two, number three, and number four. There is in every row on this side four doubles. You start or end with two doubles in one stitch. Now we skip that stitch, you make a chain one, and we go in the chain one from the previous row, and there you make one double crochet. And then over the other stitches, that is three stitches, you make one double in each stitch. So you have four doubles in a row here. This is number three, and one in the turning chain is number four, three. Chain one. In the first four, you make again one double crochet. One. That's number two. Every row you move the chain one place up. If it's to the left or to the right, you will place one further. So every time, here's chain one, you make one double crochet in there. And then chain one, skip one stitch, and in the next two you make one double crochet. Now the chain one has moved up one place, and that's what we want. It's number two, and here again two double crochets. It's number one and number two. Chain one and turn. In the first again two doubles, so that's number one and number two. In the following two stitches you'll make one double crochet, so that's number one and number two. That makes four doubles on this side. Now chain one, skip the double here and go into the chain one space, and there you make one double crochet, and over the other stitches as well up until you have eight doubles on this side. So after the chain one up to the straight line edge you need eight doubles, and then we start the next section of four double crochets. Here it is, I'll show you. You see that it goes diagonal, so here it goes. Every time it moves with one stitch. On this side you will keep four doubles in a row. Chain one, two, four, six. In this row we will have seven doubles in a row. That's number one, number two, number three, number four, number five, six, and one in a chain one space makes number seven. Chain one, skip one stitch, and go over the next two stitches. You make one double crochet in each stitch. That's one, and that's number two. And in the last stitch, you make two double in there. So one and number two. Four doubles on this side. That's correct. Chain one, turn. In the first stitch, again, two double crochets. One and number two. In the following two stitches, one double crochet. That's number three and number four. Now, skip this stitch, make a chain one, and we go into the chain one space, and you make only double crochets throughout this row. So included the chain one space from the previous row. It's number two, number three, number four, number five, and this is the sixth double crochet, number seven, and number eight. Here it is. And now, chain one and turn. Like I told, we have 8 double crochets. Now we start the second group of double crochet, 4 double crochets in a row. So here, there should be the chain one space and 4 doubles after. So we start with 4 doubles in a row. In the first stitch, you make 1 double crochet as the first. The second, third, and the fourth double crochet. We skip that stitch, so we make 1 chain, skip it, and then on top of the next 3 double crochets you make 1 double on top of it. So that's the first double crochet, the second double crochet, the third double crochet, and the fourth in the chain 1 space. Chain 1, skip the first following double crochet, and in the next 2 you make 1 double crochet. That's number 1 and number 2. And in the last stitch, so that for me is the chain 1s that I make for turning my work. Chain 1 and turn. Now you see that I've got my second group. On this side you will keep 4 doubles. From here on, this part should become with 5 rows of 4 double crochets separated by the chain 1. So you keep on going up until we have 4 doubles in a row spaced with 1 chain, not count with this side, only with the rows between the 4 in the beginning and 4 at the end. So you'll start every time with 8 double crochets in the beginning before you start with the next row of 4 doubles. I'll show you. So number 3 and number 4, a chain 1, skip the double from the previous row. In the chain 1 you make 1 double crochet, and 3 following, that makes 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Chain 1, double in the chain 1 space from the previous row. And now you count up until you have again 8 doubles on this side. So up towards the, on the side of the straight edge. When you have 8 doubles at that side, you're good to go to make your next section of 4 doubles, split it by a chain 1. This is how it looks like right now. Chain 1, turn. In the first 5, again, you make 1 double crochet, and in the chain 1, you make 1 double crochet as well. So that's number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5. And now we're in the chain 1, you make 1 double in there, and you make a chain 1, skip the double, in the next 3 doubles you make 1 double on top of them. That's the first, the second, and the third. Plus 1 in the chain 1 space is number 4. Chain 1, skip 1 stitch, in the next 2 you make 1 double. Sorry if I'm going a little bit too fast, but you can always press the pause button and crochet along. I really tried to make the tutorial not that long, and so please use the pause button between if you need it. In last stitch, 2 double crochets, and that way I've got 4 doubles at the edge again. This is how it looks like. So now again, I already made my chain 1. In the first stitch you make 2 double crochets, number 1 and number 2. In the two stitches after, you will make 1 double in each stitch. 1 and number 2, that makes 4. And now, chain 1, skip the double and go into the chain 1 and make your double crochet plus 3 doubles in a row after. So that makes 4 doubles in a row. And here's number 4. Chain 1, skip the double, go into the chain 1 and crochet doubles up until you have 8 stitches on the straight edge. It's number 3, number 4, number 5, number 6, and number 7. So I need one more row before I can split up for a next section of 4 doubles split spaced by a chain 1. So this row will be 8 doubles in a row, so 1 in the first, the second, the third is here, is number 4. Sometimes I'm stuck as well in between the 3 threads that this yarn has. This yarn is really soft, I can highly recommend it to you. It's number 6, number 7, and number 8. Chain 1 and make the 4 in a row, so that means 3 doubles on top plus 1 in the chain 1 space. It's number 3 and 1 in the chain 1 space. Chain 1, skip 1 stitch. In the next 2 you make 1 double. And of course in the last stitch 2 doubles because it's a diagonal edge. This number 2, here's chain 1 that I always use. I really highly recommend it to do it like this. You will see it later on when you want to attach a border or something like that, that this is a really nice way. So here I've got 8 doubles in a row. Now we start the next row with 4 doubles split by a chain 1. Now only we do it from the other side, so it does not matter if you start from the straight edge or the diagonal edge. Always when you have done in the previous row 8 doubles, in the row after you need to split it up till you have 4 with a chain 1 space separated. So this is 4 doubles, chain 1. In the chain 1 space you make a double crochet. Plus over the next 3 stitches you make 1 double crochet on top of them. 1, number 2, and number 3. So that's actually 4 in a row, including the stitch in the chain 1 space. Now in the next 4 you make 1 double crochet. 1, 2, included the chain 1 space. Please don't forget that one. It's number 4. Now I've got 5 stitches left on the edge. Chain 1, skip 1 stitch, and the last 4 stitches you make 1 double crochet. So this is the way you will be increasing one side and moving up the chain spaces. Chain 1 and turn. I'll show you. So I've got the second row of 4 double crochets. So from the first chain space up to the last chain space is the amount of rows that I will advise you to make. So for this will be 5 rows of 4 double crochets, and that's what you're going to do this week. Keep on repeating this up until you have 5 rows of 4 double crochets. On this side you will have 4 doubles, on this side you will have 4 doubles. Every time a chain 1 to space them up and move the chain 1 up. So these lines will go along with the shawl. On this side you will be crocheting up until you have 8 doubles. In the next row you will make a chain 1 space and move it up all with 1 stitch. So, and in the other side always increase with 2 stitches. Well, hereby I've got 5 rows of 4 doubles splitted by a chain 1 space here. Don't count the outer edge, only between the first and the last chain 1 space here. That should be 5 groups of 4 double crochets in a row. Then you're good to go and off to week 2 or part 2. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and hope to see you next week. Don't forget to give the thumbs up for this tutorial. And if you have any questions about the tutorials, please click on the link below. There you will find a link to the Facebook page which you can join. There you'll find question topics and progress topics. So I hope to see you there. When you ask any questions here on this YouTube channel. I do not always see the questions, so it is possible that your question will be answered but a little bit later on. So if you want direct answer, please go to the group and join us, and hope to see you there. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Part 2 is coming. Hope you enjoy.